Hey guys, welcome back to Face It TV. I'm Daniel DDK Kapadi. You've joined us for map number 2 for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. It is clan-mystik against Kick, and clan-mystik won 21-19. So that's what happened with the overtime. So short and sweet that overtime, but clan-mystik managed to win it. Which, I mean, the implications are pretty huge. This is their map. It's going to be a favored situation for them. So Kick really needs to come out huge here. And it's funny because in the player chat, we actually saw Kenny is saying to Fox, I'm really starting to hate you, just because Fox was basically the guy who was in most rounds taking out Kenny S in not only the AWP duels, but just, you know, in any round, any situation that Kenny S tried to face Fox. So, I mean, with that kind of feeling, you know, Fox is really hitting his shots and Kenny S maybe not feeling it so far. That could actually even be the difference. It really depends. I'm very, very curious to see how that goes. But we're jumping into the knife round now to decide who's going to start out on which team. And of course, the winner of this match, and it is match point for clan-mystik, will play in the grand finals of the GSL Egamingbets Cup against Hellraisers, which is, of course, the Exodus on the Dragons team. And they are playing for a chunk of that $2,000. And look at this, look at the line holding strong right there. All right, I'm kind of just admiring how serious they're taking this knife round. I mean, to be honest, Nuke, it is super serious. You want to start CT. Like, you really, really want to start CT. So, very important. And look at that. Actually, clan-mystik going to win that. They're definitely staying. So, we'll have the pistol round coming up now with clan-mystik starting as CT on their map against Kick, who will be terrorists, of course. So, jumping into this, Kick going to feel a lot of pressure to win this one. I would like to see them just hitting outside hard. I love seeing the chaos that ensues when that happens. But, of course, it's up to them. Let's see what call they're going to make. Tossing in some grenades at the start there. And Kenny, yes, look at this. The pre-nade there, that is one reason why going outside very fast can be kind of a bad decision to make. They can circle around for it and do it delayed outside. There is basically a huge amount of options available to them that they can go for. At the moment, they're deciding just to chill and wait for a pick. You can see like their movement here now into the upper bomb site, jumping in delayed upper so they won't fall to those grenades. And now Kick have taken control. 3 frags, no answer. In fact, 4 frags with no answer. SF now the last man standing. He's picking himself up Kenny S's USP Stainless. And that does look like it's from GoldenEye, I have to say. That does look like it's the exact same weapon from GoldenEye. Perhaps that's why Kenny S uses it. But either way, SF maybe going to try to find some cheeky frags. Oh, no. He was about to take the shot. He lined it up, and it was ruined by RMN. Getting the aim punch there as he shot the Glock into him. Unfortunate. So 1-0 Kick, winning that very required first pistol round. And actually, from what I'm recalling, yes, of Kick's play on Group A, they did like to take it slow. They did like to take it slow on Nuke as a terrorist side. So we'll probably end up seeing that quite often from them, unless they have some kind of read that playing it very fast is going to work out very well. I feel like they're going to default to a very slow play. And even on Inferno, we saw from them, they like to use their time a bit more than the average team. They like to really use their time. And, oh, look at this. The spam on the box there. Dropping SF to 45 health. They have a good read in his position. Pistol coming into play there. Oh, wow. He actually bought armor. They've all bought pistol armor here. So if they die, it's going to be a bit annoying. If they don't win this, it's going to be a bit annoying. They'll still have to do the double eco regardless. So it's okay. They still have some money left over, so it's not too horrendous, but definitely very, very poor result. SF unable to find a single frag there. They get the bomb down on the lower side. And here we go, clan-mystik jumping on in. Great shot there coming in from the 5-7 of Hearts as a motion stock on the site. P90 in hand. He's looking for the spray downs there. And look at Fox, just the lawnmower in action. Does take down the rest of the clan-mystik players. Kick taking the next round. And again, of course, you know, the pistol armor works out well because they're going to have to eco this round anyway. And even if they saved before. So It's going to work out pretty awesomely, and they're going to be able to buy next round as planned and kick 2-0 up right now. Going to hold on to that P90 as a motion. Vox going to take control of outside. We're not seeing anything intense from clan-mystik off the start. They're just stacking the upper site somewhat. Three players. RMN going to drop SF immediately at the round begins. And Kick have a very strong chance to take this down. They are keeping things real right now. You do have to worry about the upper stacks. That is something that is a very common stack that people like to make on the anti-eco or other eco rounds. But you can see they're being really careful for that. And clan-mystik are like, well, let's just get this over with. And kind of running into lobby right there. The headless chickens all going down one after another. And there it is. Just one player left, Kenny S. And actually, Kenny S might be able to make a frag here. Look, this could be a free frag. Yes, it is going to be a frag, surely. And he's going to get the AK. And it's a spin around for the shot. Doesn't find it, though. But I love that from Kenny S. Trying some magic right at the end of the round. 3-0 for Kick as expected after the pistol round. And here we have the buy now for clan-mystik. Of course, we're not going to have any AWP on Kenny S just yet. They were a bit too poor for such a move. And we could very well see them giving up outside almost completely, just allowing it to go freely, more or less, to Kick. But they do have a player playing on main. So that's all right. And we can see Iron Man, he's looking for that player, breaking open the door. And that is a timing thing as well. If you break open the door, you get the timing on the guy going main. So, and you can get the timing on the guy going main from Hut as well. But Hut is a more dangerous option as you're vulnerable from the guy who's at the top of the ladder. So here they are. They're going to charge through onto upper now as they manage to secure main. They're out on the upper side. There's one more on the floor. He gets dealt with. 3-on-2 right now. The bomb is down though. The spray coming in from Killed Dreams. He's really making a mess of things for clan-mystik. As Kenny S comes in, great headshot coming in there and trying to spray down, but the flash coming in. So very tough, very, very tough there for clan-mystik. And another eco. Depressing stuff from clan-mystik. Kick doing what they absolutely need to do. And let's not forget the clan-mystik, it is their match point. So Kick Esports are really looking for the victory here. Otherwise they are gone. This is their, they have no more lives, no more chances. They lose this, they're out, and no grand finals for them. Here you go. Tossing over the HE there. So Mutaris in this great position at radio. Look at these pixels that he's aiming at right now. Just lining it up perfectly, trying to harass. And this also, it's also not necessarily about getting a frag. It's more about locking down that angle to prevent the clan-mystik side from feeling like they can push that area. Because if they don't get any resistance there at all, then they'll start feeling like they can get aggressive. And that really kind of constricts Kick from making movements and really puts the clock on them even more. It's a good little frag there from Kenny S. Catching Fox, you know, they gave up outside and very well-placed flashbang from Emotion there through the door. But still, not much action here. Finally, Iron Man gets the pick on SF in ramp. That's going to allow their team to start making moves. He gets the second man in ramp as well. And the frags are happening all over the map as they try to synchronize on the upper side as well as he charges, as Iron Man charges around to the ladder room. Good frag onto Hiroshima right at the end there. Emotion with a team kill. But it's okay. You can see his money is terrible, but his teammates are quite affluent, so they can drop him if need be. But that was a very well played round from Kick. Very, very well played. Good patience coming in from them. Clan-mystik did a very good job. They understood like that, you know, what was happening there. They gave up outside. They put Kenny S in a very good position to deal with that, to deal with the flanker. But still, Kick remained patient. But here they are, patient no more, rushing the upper site. Very, very hard rush coming in here. But this is the problem. If you get unlucky on the setup, it's going to be a mess. And that's exactly what happened. Clan-mystik absolutely created a massive mess, created the graveyard on the upper bomb site. And that's unfortunate. That's a big gamble right there from Kick. You know, sometimes the setup is perfect, sometimes it's not for the CTs. And right now, I mean, clan-mystik, they haven't had a big presence outside, mostly because they haven't been having the weapons to do it. And some teams just don't like to go outside that much on this map. especially how powerful, considering how powerful the smokes are. Oh my god, what an insane headshot under Kenny S. That is ridiculous there. Kenny S is not having a fun time in this best of three with those shots going around, finding his head. Fox gonna try to make his way to main, gets cut off. SF up the ladder, doing a great job as well. And here comes another player, Kill Dreams coming through Hut. He gets taken down, and it just after that initial frag, it all went crazy. I mean, clan-mystik still took the round, but Kenny S, he's just getting the worst of it every time, just getting hit in the head from these ridiculous angles. Kenny S now buying an AWP. First time we see this on him. And we have a pistol round now from Kick, who are losing that momentum, losing that money situation that was looking so promising at the beginning. So on Kenny S to see how he plays this. Good angle there, looking for the initial boost spot that sometimes they like to do. And now moving towards the door. So Kenny S trying to cover those angles. And here goes the flash, little pop flash over his shoulder there. And here comes a player. And oh no, Kenny S actually connects the shot, but it is a leg shot. SF does finish it off, but the problem is that, you know, it's annoying to just keep dying, I think, for Kenny S at this point. At least he gets his AWP back. That is at least very good news for him. But he played that really well. Overall, just very unfortunate that he was aiming at slightly too low on the flick. And here we have clan-mystik bringing it back at the moment. We have a scar on GMX, probably on he's going outside, actually. And the scar outside, of course, you know, we're talking about how amazing the smokes are, how that really prevents AWPing from working that well. What's the solution? The solution is in GMX's hands. It's a scar, you can really spam that, and it's very effective. Got flashed out of his position, though, and those smokes are... GMX is making the call to his teammates that Yard is covered in smoke, he can't see anything, and you can see he's spamming away there. They really don't know what's happening, and all the while you can see that Kick Esports are actually setting up around lobby right now. So I think they're taking a bit too long. I think clan-mystik are actually beginning to figure out what's happening here. But let's see if it's successful regardless, as SF joins his teammate over at ramp. They're still Kick. They really like to take their time. And Fox is going to actually get a frag out of that. So it's going pretty well. But here they are charging into the ramp area. A couple of them, they get taken down. Killdreams, they actually line up for him, but he doesn't. But they aren't able to actually make the frag onto Killdreams. He gets two players. They secure the site. Kick Esports have this in the bag, surely. It's a one-on-two, though. And SF is going to crawl through the hut, which is smoked, which is actually kind of an okay situation for him. But SF going to get taken out. So Emotion putting in the last frag there to win the round. 6-3. Clan-mystik having a very, very, very turbulent half on the CT side. This is not looking good for them. And Kick, this is another game I can feel it. It's going to go to an overtime. I'm calling it right now. It's going to an overtime. And Kick are just playing so well today. And clan-mystik are having a bit of a hard time dealing with them. But we're still seeing very well executed aggressions and defenses from both teams regardless. So let's see how this round goes. We can check out all these players charging down T Red right now. Kenny S, they are lining up again for him. Can only get one though. Not the best weapon for spraying them down, but here comes Mutris from Hut. Great angle. Only gets one though before the trade comes in inevitably, as Kick have won their position on the secret and they move ever forwards. And here, oh, they heard the drop there. I think that was, it sounded like a player dropping either from a ladder or from cat to upper to the vents. That's what that drop sound was. So they should have figured that out. So they know that there's someone very close to the vents. That's what that sound told them. There goes GMX dropping down. He's spamming in, does catch Emotion with a headshot. And GMX makes the call now. Kill the diffuser. The bomb is down on the site. They know exactly how to play this out from this position. It's just Fox and Killdreams left. And here is SF taking it slow, but he's going to get his head popped right off there by Killdreams. And moving forwards here, see the bomb is getting planted. Hearts is there looking at the planter, covered. Good cover there. GMX now wants to try, see if he can salvage the round, if he can make it happen. Stuck in the vents, and that's where he's going to stay. 7-3 now, as Kick are doing amazingly. And this is just so brutal right now. So brutal on the CT side, only to get three rounds.
after 10 rounds. That's not so good. That's looking very bad. Kick are just going to be feeling better and better about themselves. They're going to start feeling more and more confident about taking their shots, about their strategies, about their execution. They are going to be loving life. And oh, Mutris almost getting a pick there over at ramp. Here goes the pistol from Kiyoshima into lobby. Not successful though. And we're seeing no players dead yet for clan-mystik. They have a deagle in play from SF. I mean, that's what his plan was, to try and make the pick into lobby, move in, one shot, get one kill, but didn't work out for him, unfortunately. He's repositioned now. This is a great position because he can take the shot and then fall back down if he misses. Of course, the deagle's really only going to be good for one shot. You can see he takes a shot, falls back down. He can take another angle, needs to fall back down again after that. That's how the deagle can really work well. And that's why it's generally better defensively when you're on the pistol or the eco rounds. Here goes Kiyoshima. That goes in again. Beautiful stuff there. He said 75. Really worth its weight in gold at this point. And there goes Kenny S trying to find the head of Kill Dreams. But he's not going to be able to do so. Mystic finding an AK there onto Kiyoshima. Here goes SF. Beautiful use of the deagle. Getting a one-for-one trade. That's actually brilliant. It's actually 4 versus 3 in the favor. GMX. Oh my god. What a shot from GMX. Kill Dreams trying to bring things back into control for Kick, and he's doing just that. It's 2-on-2 right now, even tapping a bullet into his teammate as Kiyoshima tries to defend from the doors, going for the shot. Does, oh my goodness. We have Mutris getting taken down. Kiyoshima with the AK-47 that he picked up. What a wonderful round from clan-mystik, scrapping together that round with the pistols. They worked that so well. And I think it was SF who charged into Hut initially with the deagle, or maybe it was Kiyoshima, whatever. They didn't lose their life, and they spotted a lot of players and fell back, repositioned off of that knowledge, and it worked out really, really well for them. So Kick now, they're still feeling good. I mean, they got the 7 rounds. They can be happy with 7 to 8. They can really be happy with that. Any more rounds that they get is a massive bonus. They're still going to be feeling good. But the more important thing is that clan-mystik, after that victory, that is a huge momentum changer. Winning a pistol round like that, winning an eco like that, it's going to really help your team. You know, the good emotions are going to start flooding back in. And here they go, rushing the upper site again. Kiyoshima from the catwalk is putting in mad work with the AK-47. Kenny S double scoping his way to victory in that round. 7-5 now as clan-mystik claw their way back into this game, this second map nuke, in which they have, as I trip over my words, they have match points. So they want to close this out. They don't want to play into the early hours of the morning. They want to play this out, get this done right now. They don't want to make it a third map. They know that their strengths lie here. They got to put all the focus into this map right now. But Kick, they're just so strong right now. They're just feeling so good. So here we have a play coming in from Fox on the outside. We haven't seen a lot of outside work from Kick. They've actually made more things happen from moving into upper with just maybe one man outside. They haven't done a lot of rushing down the secret like we see from NIP. They love to do that. And other teams as well like to carpet outside full of smoke. Don't see that a lot from Kick so far, but they're finding their successes regardless. And there's Kenny S with the HE. There goes the player. Kenny S deals with him. And there goes the push out of Hut. The synchronization is pretty good right now, but Kiyoshima's position, it is masterfully executed as he and Hut just gun down the aggression. Fox is remaining. He's going to get one kill, but that's going to be it. 3 players left alive. Clan-mystik are really doing this, and the battle of the door. So, 7-6. Again, Kick going for the pistol. And we must wonder what they're going to do with this one. I'd like to see a fast swarm on either outside or ramp. Let's see something fast for this pistol round. It is so fun to see the Zerg kind of strategy, the Zerg rush through onto upper. It seems that's what their choice right now. They're feeling good for it. But both players on the floor immediately. That is a very good way to defend an aggression such as that. And they're going to take it down 7-7 now as we move on to the last round of the first half. And again, Kick They don't care. They've got their seven rounds. They are so happy right now. But they want to make this even easier for themselves. And to do that, they have to win this round. They got the five AKs. And they have been having a lot of success with the upper pushes, generally speaking. So I'm curious if they're just going to keep sticking with that. Maybe make a delayed upper push. And you can see that clan-mystik, they have been quite aware of this. They've been changing their setup based on kind of the moves that Kick can be making. Oh, wow. Kenny S. Big frag coming out from Kenny S there from the dog walk. And he's going to fall on back. He knows that his position's compromised at this point. They know exactly where he is. So he's going to change up. Look at that. Hearts pushing from Secret. Going to take down Kill Dreams. So their presence outside is now eliminated. And they're deciding to just go for it now. They're going to make the play. This is the last ditch attempt. Can they make it work? Great headshot there onto Kenny S, who falls top of ladder. SF dropped on the site as well. Muter is trying to spam through the smoke. It is him versus Kyoshima. Going to pick up that bomb right now. Wait for the shot. Wait for the shot. Now he's going to go for the plant. Kyoshima is waiting. He's got the HE. They're going to throw it clean through. Oh, doesn't quite land it perfectly. That's okay. There goes the flash. It is tense right now. There he is. And he's just going to make it happen. Beautiful play from Kick right there. 8-7 first half. That's a great way to start off Nuke as the terrorist side. That is really nice. So big pressure again on clan-mystik to win this pistol round. Let's see what they are going to step up to the plate with. It's got to be good. There is no holding back right now for clan-mystik. Kick here to send a statement home that they are a really, really, really awesome team that deserves a huge amount of recognition. I would love to see them make the grand finals, but I'd love to see either of these teams make the grand finals. They're both equally deserving at this point. The games are going so close that it's hard to even separate them. But here we go. We got some action on ramp as Killdreams falls back. Very smart decision from Killdreams not to try to stand alone against five players. Going to wait for his teammates to help him out as we have an occupation right now over at the ramp room. They're going to take that occupation down onto the lower bomb site where, oh my god, RMN's going to go down to the grenade. It's a 3-on-2. Make that 2-on-5 now. 1-on-5. Oh my god, Kyoshima. Couple taps right at the end. Going to take the round down without losing a single player. 8-8 right now. And very wonderful result for clan-mystik, who take the pistol round. And I want to see some sick strats coming out. Some very well executed smokes and grenades. Well timed, well placed. From clan-mystik, of course. And they're going to take this anti-eco round, it seems. And they're going to spread it out. They're going to spread Kenny S into the outside. He's going to be there somewhat alone. And he's got Galil, so if he does die there, he gives away the Galil. It's not a huge problem. You don't want to stick the AK guy out there, alone at least, just in case something happens. Kenny S is going to find a frag. His teammates, SF and Kyoshima, chiming in as well. And look at that, Kyoshima going to find the frags with the USPS. And there you go. Very clean, very fast anti-eco round. And now we're going to see the next one as well. So what are we in store for right now here for the GSL Egamingbets Cup? And clan-mystik. Let's check things out on the scoreboard. Yeah, of course we can see Kiyoshima. He's really very far ahead on the frags right now. 21 on the board. So definitely having a good game at the moment. Spam coming through right there. And we've got the movement outside with the bomb. They are probably not going to go down secret necessarily. They don't have to at least. They can really take out, they can take control of all of the outside against the pistols. And look at that. There's a player creeping up secret and might just catch someone in the side. It's going to be a motion. He's going to go down. And it's a very easy follow-up here for clan-mystik. They can just spread out along the map really. But look, RMN is going to put some troubles in clan-mystik's way by taking out a GMX. But they're still only 4-on-3, it's okay. But these new pistols, some of them are pretty dangerous, and you've got to be careful, but clan-mystik, they will tidy the round up, 10-8. But here's where it gets interesting. We get the buy from Kick Esports. Here comes the buy. Fox could go AWP and no Kevlar. I think that's what he did. Let's go check Fox out there. No, he actually managed to buy, I guess. He did buy the Kevlar, got the AWP thrown over to him. So good stuff coming in here. I am very curious to see if Fox is going to be able to grab a quick opening frag. And they're not going to put anyone outside very quickly. They have a man over at T-Red, actually. It's Muteris. Oh, and he might catch GMX off guard. He does just that. Beautiful frag. There's another player there. Will he decide to go for it or fall back? Both plays can be considered okay here, but would really like to take that advantage and fall back with it as his position is now compromised. But it's going to be Hearts who's going to come in to try to nade him out from that position. And he does take a lot of damage from the grenades. He's on 21 health now, but he's going to fall back. They did a great job opening up the round there, and Kick with that play are going to put themselves in the lead. Look at that. Fox was waiting for that. Kyoshima's head just splatting across the squeaky door room. SF now holding down radio. And Fox, man, you cannot test him. You cannot deny him the frags with the AWP. He's just so good for it right now. SF trying to put the spam in there with the P90. That's all it's really good for, especially since the nerf. I'm sure many, many people couldn't sleep at night after they read the changelog and seeing the P90 nerfed a little bit. Here goes SF into the hut there, perhaps, trying to catch an aggression from Kick. And this is really problematic now because it's just SF and Hearts left. SF is going to swap for an AK, which is a great decision. Iron Man's going to get aggressive. He wants a frag. He wants to hunt down the remaining player there, but he's not going to find him. And it seems like they're just going to go and chill right now, try to save these weapons. 2-on-5 is just not a good situation. And looking at the money right now, let's have a quick look. They do actually have a lot of money, but they can drop the weapons to the guys who died and buy up themselves. And we're looking at 10-9 scoreline at the moment. So it is going to go down to the wire. We're having a round-for-round kind of game between these two teams. Even NIP and Hellraisers, that was going pretty round-for-round towards the end, at least. Look at this aggression coming in. Fox gonna make the peek. SF ready for it though, denying entry. Oh wow, he's gonna go down as well. So they have opened up the ramp room. Things get chaotic now. There's three players left. Big gamble coming in from Kick. It's not gonna pay off now as they have to just scatter even around the bomb sites, trying to figure out how they even position themselves to deal with the oncoming players of clan-mystik as they flood into the A bomb site. And Hearts is going to get the plant for main right now. And it's just one player left, it's RMN, and he's of course going to go for this sneaky play here. He's not going to be able to retake the site, so he's just going to chill, try to keep that weapon alive, get some exit frags perhaps, as they try to hunt him down. And here comes Kenny S. Oh, this could be a huge kill to pick up. Kenny S holding the AWP. There it is. Takes down Kenny S. He heard more stepping. He knows there's another one that's coming around the corner. He takes him down as well. If he can get the kills and even save the AWP. That, oh my god, RMN with the third frag. He wants that AWP so badly. Here comes another player. Should be able to swap that weapon. Nope. Not in time. He's just going to keep himself alive right now. He's done an amazing job. He removed three weapons. And I think everyone died there. So the AWP is lost as well. Big, big play from Kick Esports RMN at the end there, taking down all the weapons of the four remaining players. That is massive. That's a big, big, big pressure on the economy. And had they not had to rebuy those weapons, they wouldn't be in such a fragile position. And we're entering the stage of the game where the economy still matters quite a lot, quite massively. And if clan-mystik have problems with this round, they may even have to eco, I believe. Okay, they won't have to eco necessarily, but if they lose a couple in a row, they'll start having to eco. And it would have been a much different situation otherwise. SF going for the challenge. He wins the challenge. Here goes the motion to equalize. Catches Kenny S with the AWP. There's another player for him to find in GMX. GMX wins the duel, but the trade is there from Fox. We're on a 3-on-3 now, and this is always good for the T's right now because they have a situation where they get to choose where do we attack as three, whereas the Kick CAT side, they have to be like, okay, where do we defend? We have to split up. And oh my god. I think Kyoshima's life just flashed before his eyes and he gets clipped by an AWP bullet from Fox. Not many people get to tell the tale after entering a duel with Fox, but Fox is missing his shots and Kyoshima is going to take him down with a headshot. It's a 2-on-2 now, two Famuses against two AKs. Muteris in a position that is quite stressful to deal with as he has to look at two angles, but here he knows now he's got a bearing on where they're going to be. One from Hut, and there it is. Got to be careful not to get caught with the grenade out. Hut's making the move onto the upper bomb site there. Here goes the flash. going to get him into a position to deal with Mutarius in main. He takes him down. One player, top of ladder, they know it. This is the plant for main. Nothing that Iron Man can do from that position. It has to turn the corner. There it is. Does take down one player. It's a one-on-one. Cannot do it. Kiyoshima will secure the round for clan-mystik as they go 12-9. This is match point for clan-mystik against Kick for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And tensions are high right now as Kick are on a pistol round and clan-mystik are really solidifying their economy, really stabilizing it at this point. After this victory, you know, if they are going to get it, it's going to be really nice for them. They won't. I don't think they'll have to really worry for the rest of the match, really, all that much. But the spray down on the pistoling players of Kick is all too easy. 13-9 there, and we move to the next round. There we go. We're getting the buy coming in from Kick now. No money for the AWPs though, which of course changes the playstyle, changes the possibilities. Not having an AWP on Fox obviously is a big loss for Kick. When you've got such a strong AWPer, you're definitely playing from a position of less advantage than you could possibly have, but that's just how the money works. So let's see how they're going to change their setup based on Fox not having an AWP. And we can already see that the change in the setup is kind of aggressive on ramp, kind of giving up outside. That's the play they're making here. Tight control on upper, aggression on ramp, find the information quickly, and then react very fast and dynamically with their movements. And clan-mystik throwing in the smokes, being very cautious, very slow and deliberate as they push outside. There go the smokes, timing is perfect, and out they go. We've got clan-mystik jumping down secret. Here goes the motion. Perfectly timed smoke. This is so important. Delaying is really important here. There is still a lot of time left in the round, and Emotion's there pretty much alone, so there won't be a re-smoke. GMX going to find Fox over at the ladder room. Take him down. This is very stressful for the CTs again, because now they have to think about flanks. So here you go, Kenny S now finally waiting out that smoke. Pops off the head of Emotion as they move forwards. Now that should allow them to get onto a situation where they can create a plant. And here it is, GMX again taking down RMN. See how much trouble he's causing. Finally he gets taken down, but he's already done too much damage. Kyoshima going to take down Kill Dreams as Mutarius stays flush against the wall to take down Kenny S. But there's not much for him to do there. Clan-mystik look like they're going to take another round here. Three players left with the bomb down. And this is very bad for Kick right now. Very, very bad. Look at the money here. They're going to need to eco. And that should be a game-winning situation for clan-mystik. It should be, in theory. Nice reactions here from Mutarius, but how long can he keep himself alive? Here comes a player from Secret. He heard him. Does take him down. He's got another player he wants to challenge, but can he get around the corner? Good little bunny hopping there from Mutarius to survive, and he will keep his AK alive. Could be the difference. That could be the difference. We've seen top teams with a situation like one AK saved, for example, when almost nothing can save them, basically, from losing the match. A cute little aggression set up behind it, and things happen. We've got a scout, we've got a famous, we've got double mags and an AK. This is going to be a creative round from Kick. And to win this match from this point, they have to get creative. Two more rounds for clan-mystik. They felt like they were forced for the buy, and with that AK-47 saved, and that's what they're going for. Fox is the man with the scout, of course. And here we go. We've got movement over at ramp. Instantly, Kill Dreams is taken down, and we have a lot of presence on the A bomb site still from Kick, but they know now that ramp is compromised. Got to move down to the lower site. Mutarius is the man with the AK in his hands, the man with the power to create a difference for his team. There is SF, drops Mutarius instantly, and now RMN is going to have to try to do something. 13 health though, that's surely got to be it. 15-9 though, and Kick, no money, no chances. Clan-mystik one round away for being in that grand final against Hellraisers, also known as Exosana Dragons. So happy they've picked they've got a brand now, a new brand. So Kick, they were so good in the first half. First 60-65% of the game, they looked great. But clan-mystik showing why this is their map pick towards the end here. The T half from them is so, so strong. Kick only able to get, I think, was it two rounds from the CT side so far? And look at this spray coming in. They are just walking into the fire of GMX, and they're already calling the GG. It's just Muterus left. Last man standing against four players with the FAMS, and you can see all of them on screen at once almost. 16-9, clan-mystik take it down. They are going to be in the grand final against Hellraisers. Definitely well played by Kick, and Great to see them putting up performances like that. And we're going to take a quick break, guys, and we'll be back soon with more information for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. So stay with us. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.